Hello guys, welcome to my channel. Hope all are doing good. Like, share, subscribe and click on the bell icon for latest notification of the upcoming videos. Do watch and comment for my videos. So we are into the topic of average and we are done with two sessions. So this is our third session and we'll see a set of questions in this session. Okay, so those who have missed previous videos, do watch and come here because that forms the base for these videos. Okay. So I'll provide you the link in the description box so that you can click on it and view it. Okay. Yes. So before getting into questions, we'll just brush up with the basic formula, which is nothing but average is equal to sum of all values divided by total number of values. Okay. So based on your question, you can change your formula. Suppose they have given you the average and total number of values. You can calculate the sum of all values by multiplying average and total number of values. Okay. So based on your question, you can change the formula. Okay. Let's start with the first question. A class has two sections, in one of which there are 40 students with an average age of 14.5 years. The average age of the class is 14.2 years. If there are 32 students in the other section, then its average age is. So understand the question carefully, otherwise you will go wrong. Okay. So they said that a class has two sections. Let us consider it to be A and B, and A has 40 students and its average age is 14.5. Okay. Then what they have said, the average age of a class is 14.2 years. So listen to it carefully, not that of section B, but of the class. That means A plus B together, its average is nothing but 14.2. Okay. Then what they have said, if there are 32 students in the other section, then its average age is. So number of students in section B also they have given, that is 32 students, and we will have to find the average age of that section B. How we will find? Just imagine, total is nothing but A plus B. Total strength of the class is nothing but strength of section A plus strength of section B, right? So simple, use this logic and solve the question. So we want total value, I mean total age of section A and total age of section B. How we will do that? We know number of students and average age. Using that we will do. Okay, let us see how to do. So first write down what are all the numbers given. So section A has 40 students and section B has 32 students. And section A average age they have given it as 14.5 years. And section B is what we'll have to find. So keep it as X. Always remember what you have to find, you keep that as X. Okay, here we'll have to find the average age of section B. So keep that as X. This should be equated to what? The third value, the total number. So how we'll get that? So 40 in one section and 32 in other section means on total it is 72. Totally there are 72 students in that class, right? So 72 into, they have given the average age of the class as 14.2 years. So simply equate 40 into 14.5 plus 32 into X is nothing but equal to 72 into 14.2. So the value is, on multiplying you get it as 1022.4. Okay. So you just equate and then solve by simplifying. Okay. So 40 into 14.5 is nothing but 580 plus 32 into X. You can write it as 32X, which is equal to 1022.4. So taking 580 to right hand side, you'll get it as 1022.4 minus 580. On subtracting, your value is 442.4. So 32x is equal to 442.4. So x is equal to 442.4 divided by 32. When you simplify, you get the final answer as x is equal to 13.825. So what this denotes? The average age of section B is nothing but 13.825. Okay. See the next question. In a school with 600 students, so total they have given us 600 students. The average age of the boys is 12 years and that of girls is 11 years. If the average of the school is 11 years, 9 months, then the average number of girls in the school is. So we'll keep the average number of girls in the school as X. Okay. That is what we'll have to find. Okay. So what all information they have given? They have given the total number of students as 600 and their average also they have given. That is 11 years, 9 months. So, right hand side is done. Okay. Now, left hand side, what all is given? They are given only average age of boys and average age of girls. They haven't mentioned both number of boys or number of girls in our question. So, what it will do? We know the total number, right? 600. So, let us consider the number of girls to be X, right? So, boys will be 600 minus X, right? See, total is 600 and we know girls are X, means boys would be the remaining 600 minus girls, right? So, we'll keep like that. So, we know the average 12 years and 11 years. So, simply you can equate 12 into 600 minus X plus 11X is equal to 600 into 11 years and 9 months they have given. So, you will have to convert it into years. So, how we will convert month into year? Just divided by 12. So, 9 by 12. On simplification, it would be 3 by 4, right? So, it is a mixed fraction. Convert it into improper fraction. So, 4 into 11, which is 44, plus 3, which is 47, divided by 4. So, on simplification and taking all the X terms to one side and numbers to other side, you get the value as 150. So, the average number of girls in the school is 150. Okay, hope you understood. See the next question. Try to solve it by yourself. 16 children are to be divided in two groups A and B of 10 and 6 children. So, totally 16 children they have given and A is 10 children and B is 6 children. The average person marks obtained by children of group A is 75. So, A's total value we can find because we have both the number as well as their average marks. And the average person marks of all the 16 children is 76. What is the average person marks of children of group B? So, this is quite similar to your first sum. So, try to solve it by yourself. Anyway, I'll explain you. So, total is 16 and A is 10 and B is 6 children. So, average age of A is given as 75. So, total age mark of A would be 75 into 10, which is nothing but 750. And total mark of all the 16 children would be 16 into 76 because their average person mark is given as 76. So, let us equate. 16 into 76 is equal to 10 into 75 plus 6 into X because we'll have to find the average percent of marks of group B. So, that group B will be considered as X. Okay. So, now solve it and finally you'll get the answer as 77 2 by 3. Okay. See the next question, very easy. A family consists of two grandparents, two parents and three grandchildren. The average age of the grandparents is 67 years, that of the parents is 35 years and that of the grandchildren is 6 years. What is the average age of the family? So, all data they have given, we will finally have to find the average age of the family. So, simply how you can do? Two grandparents, right? So, their average age is given as 67. So, 2 into 67 plus 2 into 35 plus 3 into 6. Okay? This is nothing but your total value. But our question is find the average. So, average how we'll find sum of all values divided by total number of values. Here, total number is 2 plus 2 plus 3. 2 grandparents, 2 parents and 3 children. On total, it is 7. So, divided by 7. When you do, you get it as 222 by 7, which is on simplification get it as 31.5 by 7 years. So, this is the average age of the family. Okay. Last and the final question. The average weight of A, B and C is 45 kg. If the average weight of A and B be 40 kg and that of B and C be 43 kg, then the weight of B is C. It's a variety of question. Let's see how to solve it. It's easy only, okay? So, average weight of A, B, C is 45. So, total weight of A, B, C, how you'll find? A plus B plus C is equal to 45. So, total weight is nothing but average into number. Right? So, 45 into A plus B plus C. That means 1 plus 1 plus 1. Totally 3 members, right? So, 45 into 3, which gives you a total weight of 135. So, total weight of all the 3 members is 135. Next, if the average weight of A and B be 40 kg. So, total weight would be 40 into 2, right? Because A and B. Then, and that of B and C be 43 kg. That is average weight of B and C is 43 kg. So, 43 into 2 will give you the total weight of B and C. Okay, which is 86. Now, how we will solve? Let us consider it to be 3 equations. Okay, so first equation is that 135 second equation is a plus b and third equation is b plus c value. Okay, so just think, when you add equation 2 and 3, which is a plus b plus b plus c, what you will get? A plus 2b plus c. Okay, so when you add together, you get it as 80 plus 86, which is 166. So when you subtract this equation from a plus b plus c, first equation, you will get the value of b, right? Because a plus 2b plus c minus a minus b minus c. Okay, so you will get the value of b alone. So when you do, you will get it as 166 minus 135, which is nothing but 31. So the weight of b is 31. So I hope you understood all the questions discussed in this session. So first try to find the equation so that you can easily solve with the values. Okay, so thank you for watching this video. Don't miss out any videos. Thank you for all the support given. Keep supporting. So thank you.